Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to Star Wars The Clone Wars Season 4 Episode 5, titled Mercy Mission. C-3PO and R2-D2 explore a strange underground world. So, got absolutely no idea what this could be. I know it's a droid-centric episode based on that synopsis, but why would C-3PO and R2 be off on their own? Who knows? Were they sent to get another cake topper that sent them on a wacky adventure again? Well, wacky adventure being kidnapped? Who knows? We probably will in 3, 2, 1, go. Understanding is honoring the truth beneath the surface. Hologram almost looked like a Death Star. Why do you have a crosshair in your eye? So I'm assuming for some reason C-3PO and R2 are with this group. It'll buff out. Right here, then. Why do they sort of look like Crazy Frog? That explains why they're there. Now they think he did. Okay, so apparently the Ewoks were not the first time C-3PO was thought a god. Okay, so this episode is related to a meme I saw. It's talking about how the clones aren't really polite to C-3PO, but they know that Anakin respects R2, and so they respect him. But for some reason it said the 501st. This is not the 501st. I mean, might be like Japanese, where it's rude to eat on the streets. And let me guess, the entryway gets sealed. And is there any reason why it has to specifically be the droids that go? No, it's some other whirling thing. You just had to say that. And you're going to try Wolf, and he's not going to understand. I don't think that's daylight. I think that's bioluminescence. Is it still bioluminescence if it's plant life? What the hell is Orphney? Let me guess, they're all going to join together into a singular person. It's where you came. You are not really being helpful. You're a river. I thought it on the first line, got it on the second line. Not fire. Yeah, sure, you're welcome to believe that. Now, just slide that back into the ground. I'm sure you really did a lot of helping there. Right, okay, so that was another self-contained episode, which I was not expecting going in, considering the next episode is also an R2 and C-3PO episode. So I thought that this one would lead into that one. That's why I checked the time of my recording when they fell into the pit, because I figured, oh, that's probably how it's gonna end with them exploring it, coming across something, and then that's where it's gonna cut off. But no, it completed the story and everything. Those creatures were very funny to me. I don't know what it was about them, but they just made me laugh. But yeah, nothing really happened. At least nothing really of note, so nothing to report on. That Orphne was interesting. Obviously, at least to me, it's in reference to Greek mythology, the oracle. Yeah, I don't know if that's actually what they were going for or anything. Why did she try to eat him? Why was her first instinct when someone came seeking her help to try and eat him? It's interesting. The ones below ground say that the unfiltered air from above is poisonous to them and will kill them. Yet the unfiltered air from the ground is poisonous to the ones above and will kill them. So it is sort of good that they have the earth in place to shield the two groups. I guess it is more probably the nature in which they grew up in as to which one would be able to be tolerated. Anyway, gonna end this one here. I'll catch you in the next one.